Ahí están, ya la escucharon a Erika, ella se está lanzando para City Council del distrito de Ward 5. Y ella
well,
quiere
first
ser...
of all, thank you for having me, Rosemary, on your show. I'm so excited to be here and meet with the people. My name is Dr. Erica Smith, and I come from a little place named St. Mary's, Georgia. So I'm a Southern girl, so I bring a lot of good, I'm going to bring a good lot of Southern charm. I'm looking forward to that. Grew up in St. Mary's, went to school in Jacksonville, Florida. Actually, I went to Catholic school in Jacksonville, Florida, Holy Rosary Catholic School from 8th through 8, and then Bishop Kenny High School 9 through 12. And so then I made my way, kept moving, graduated from University of Georgia with a degree in biology, and then went on to Meharry Medical College School of Dentistry in Nashville, Tennessee. So. And then I just made my way, did my residency in Albuquerque, New Mexico at University of New Mexico. And then I moved to the fabulous city of Las Vegas in 2008. Wow. Mm-hmm. So I've been here a little while. I actually, October 31st, which is Nevada Day, is when I moved here. So very special day where I started my journey here in Las Vegas. And here I am. Okay.
Can you tell us a little bit, why is it so important for you to run in Ward 5? What difference are you going to make in the state of Nevada in Ward 5? That, I mean, is there needs that need to be met in Ward 5? Because we understand that there's a lot of need everywhere, especially in Ward 5.
Yes, thank you for asking me that. But I like to start off by saying, if not me, then who? I've decided to step into this role because I am highly equipped. By going to Meharry Medical College School of Dentistry, if you look and Google about the history of Meharry and how we have served, how they served the underserved, that is how I literally, you know, when you're going to school there, that's what you learn how to do, is you learn how to serve the underserved. So for me, that mantra is part of who I am. That's how what they rooted inside of me. So when I look at Ward 5, I see a ward that has untapped potential. And unfortunately, the current leadership and other leadership that's been there has not really tapped into the full potential of the ward. When I first moved here and I started talking to people in Ward 5, they would say, hey, you know, we were supposed to really be like Ward 2. Now, we know Ward 2 is Summerlin, and we know what Summerlin looks like. It's gorgeous. And so they said, but they gave those resources to Ward 2, to Summerlin. We were supposed to have those resources. But if you look at the rich history of even the historic West Side, you see where they had Jackson Avenue. And it used to be an area that was thriving. I just attended, they had a documentary that they just did. It's called Across the Tracks, the Historic West Side Legacy. And it was just great because you were able to see how thriving it was. I want the city of Las Vegas, Ward 5, to be thriving again. It's even a food desert now. So you talked about some of the issues. We're talking about there's still food desert in Ward 5. There's still, we have issues with affordable housing. We have issues with the fact that we need more economic development there. And so I've spoken to developers. They're ready to go. They says, Dr. Erica, we're ready to do things, but we need leadership in there where we can come and have access to you. We can talk to you. And I think the citizens and the constituents in Ward 5, they want someone that can listen, because it's not always about talking all the time. It's about sitting down, listening. I think some of the things I would like to implement would be like to have town halls so that the people can come. If we have something on the table at the city that's going to directly affect the constituents, that's something we should be bringing to the people. Let me hear what you have to say. This is what's going on. This is what we're looking to do. Now, we would like your input, because I don't think enough of that has happened. And I've attended some of the meetings in Ward 5 about the Harlem Nights Project, which has now been called the West Side Hotel Project. And as I sat there, I just felt like the people wanted to be heard. And I think that that's the thing. They're looking for a leader that can hear them. They're looking for someone that is forward thinking. They're looking for someone that can think outside the box. They're looking for someone that is a change maker. I'm all of those things. And I'm an advocate for the people. I will fight for them. in ways that they have never seen before. And I think they're looking for something fresh. They're looking for some fresh leadership, and I know that I can bring that to the table.
Let me tell you a little bit. We have been doing some campaign, in Ward 5. And, you know, I've knocked on some doors with my Hispanic community. And I see there's a lot of empty lots in Ward 5. But I also read in Ward 5 that a lot of homes were being burnt. And that was very sad to see. As an activist, I'm a pro-immigrant activist, but I'm also an activist for other communities as well. I've had to gone in there and fight for the rights of the people who live in housing because they were getting 30-day notices and 10 and 5, 15 and 5-day notices because these people didn't know how to work the new system of how to pay their rents. So I had to go in there and stop the evictions and stop the late fees because they weren't paying the rents because most of the people that live in Ward 5 don't have enough money. The people that live in the housing authority, they don't have enough money, apartments, they don't have enough money to even buy a computer, more or less pay for their internet. And so I went there and talked to them, to the commissioners, and I said, this cannot happen. All their late fees need to be given back, and all of their homes need to be reconstructed because these homes are very old. And I was because I'm a passionate community activist. And so, and I told them, I said, and go ahead and bring on a little bit of more funding because you're talking about getting funding to put up some new windows and a new lobby at the Section 8 office or Housing Authority office. But you know what? You need to retrain your workers so that when people come to the office and ask for help, they're not so rude to the people. Let's have some rehabilitation. Rehabilitate from the inside and move on to the outside. And you know what? It breaks my heart to see all those homes burning, empty lots. It looks beautiful right now because it's very clean. It's clean now. But there's a lot of need in Ward 5. I spend a lot of time in Ward 5 because I go to the Harrison House. When I need help, I go there. And I listen to the stories of the people, and that helps out a lot. Are you willing to support most of these people in your district and make those changes? Because that really, I have the stories on Facebook where I went there and I had to speak up for Ward 5.
Thank you so much for asking that question, Rosemary. I could tell you're quite passionate as well as I am as well. Yes, there are issues with fires happening in some of the vacant buildings that are in Ward 5, specifically Historic West Side. There's a big issue going on with that. There was just recently, there was a vacant lot that was just burned, and it was just very heartbreaking to see, you know, something like that happening within the community. I have heard some horror stories about the Housing Authority dealing with Marble Manor and some of the other areas in Ward 5. And so definitely they are on my list.
That is wonderful.
They're on my list because I've heard some things that frankly are disturbing and it's unacceptable. And why are you treating people like this? This whole I just hate the eviction process, period. But I think that is just backwards. The way it's done, I just don't agree with. I feel like we still have to treat people humanely and with dignity. And that's very important. So that's what I say when I say I'm fighting for you. Those are some of the issues that I want to deal with because I know that there's a problem with the Housing Authority. I've already been hearing about it. Once people know you're running for office, you get all the tea. And so people will come to you and they're spilling the tea and they're telling you everything that's going on. But that's what they're supposed to do. Because if they don't tell me, there's no way for me to know. I'm not going to know every issue. And so that's why I said having those town halls, meeting with the people is very important. That's something that should be done routinely within the entire ward. That way people have a voice. They know they can come and voice their concerns because there are things that are happening that I may not be aware of, but I need to know them. As a councilwoman, I need to know everything that's affecting you so that I know how to proceed. I know how to fight. And that's why they're calling me the people's choice.
I understand that there's a lot of crime in Ward 5 as well. Are you in support of Metro and willing to work with Metro as our new Ward 5 City Councilwoman?
Absolutely. I know we have Bold in command. And so, yes, I believe that it's very important for people to be safe. Public safety is actually one of my platforms. And so that's something I think that we have to, as a community, we have to partner with our law enforcement to make sure they're doing their job, they're doing the things they're supposed to do for the community, and that the people can really feel safe. They can trust the police, because that's the big thing in our communities. We know that trust is a big thing, and we don't always trust the police. But public safety is very important. So we have to form those partnerships, those community partnerships, and really do things especially with our Bold in Command. Absolutely.
A little bit about the businesses in Ward 5. I understand that a lot of the businesses lack employees. They lack security. You know, they don't feel safe. I've been in that area and I've spoken to some of the business owners, and they lack, some of them don't fear because they've been there for many, many years and they feel comfortable. But they say, we do need extra, security because we feel like crime is rising.
So that's a good point. When we're dealing with small businesses, and I've, been a small business owner, I still have businesses, but when you have that brick and mortar business, you need security, especially in an area that tends to have a higher rate in crime. And so that's why working with our Bold in Command, working with our police officers is very important. Maybe partnering with some private security is very important to make sure we have things in place where people can feel safe doing business in Ward 5. I want Ward 5 to be thriving. And so that means we meet with the business owners. That means we sit and say, okay, like you were able to say, we need this, 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 and this for them to be able to feel safe and do business. And also we want to make sure we're promoting their businesses, because that's very important. Small business is very important. I believe in that, as far as if they're doing business within the city of Las Vegas, that we remove some of that red tape that's happening that I hear about when people are trying to get business licenses, even at this, on the city level. So we need to make sure that we streamline that process and make it super easy, maybe give some incentives. I want there to be more businesses in Ward 5 as well. But people do have to feel safe in order to want to do business there.
I see. Let's go right into your policies. Yo le hice una preguntita a la señora Erika, que se está lanzando para el Distrito 5 de Ward 5 como City Council de Las Vegas, Nevada. Le hice unas preguntitas. Ella es católica, fue católica. Ella se vino aquí a Las Vegas. Ya tiene años aquí como residente de Las Vegas. Vamos a entrar un poquito en los policies de ella. ¿Cuál es su plataforma para poder apoyar el distrito del Ward 5? En su distrito de ella. Y hace ratito nombramos unas cositas que son muy importantes, de que en esa área se han quemado casas, en esa área se necesita mucha ayuda porque hay apartamentos de gente que no puede pagar mucha renta. Y entonces estas personas necesitaron ayuda en un momento y gracias a Dios yo pude estar ahí. Para ellos. Let's go into your supporting policies that attract private investment and economic.
Let me talk a little bit about that just shortly. So I definitely want to be able to bring in those people. I've had developers reach out to me. I've spoken to developers. I've spoken with homeowners. And so they're really very interested in doing a lot in Ward 5 because they see the same untapped potential that I do. And it's very exciting. And so I'm ready to work. And we want to bring in people that want to bring in things that are going to really uplift the community and beautify the community without gentrification, without those type of things that I know a lot of the residents are concerned about. But we do have to do things to move and progress. And so, you know, change is hard for most of us. But we have to push through. We have to bring in those developments that are going to make us, I mean, Ward 5 used to be, I mean, it's just used to be thriving. And there's no reason why we can't get back to that place and even better. And so I'm ready for developers to reach, even more developers to reach out to me. I know there's some billion-dollar projects they're looking at doing. I'm really, really excited. And they're really excited about me. And they're like, yeah, we know we can work with you. And I think that that's the thing that they've been really waiting for, mm-hmm. is someone that has some common sense and really is ready to get things moving and make things better for the community.
We understand that people are struggling right now with the high rise of inflation, the high rise of rents. People are not affording rents anymore, and they're becoming homeless. And we're talking about families with children. Right now, we see them at the parks. We see them in different areas. And people, when they talk about homeless, they think that people are just, you know, going through some mental health problems, or they're going through some type of, you know, drug addiction crisis. And that's not the situation, because we have families that don't have but one job. And either the husband has a job or the wife, and they can't afford a home. How are you willing to help these families as a city council and be able to make things happen in Ward 5, to be able to get some funding to be able to reconstruct some more homes for that?
Absolutely. And so these type of things that you're bringing up are very dear to me. A lot of people don't know I was homeless. And so I experienced that. And so I know exactly what people are going through. And it is heartbreaking. And so my thing is, this affordable housing, we have to have it. We have to have, people don't have the money doesn't stretch as far as it used to. You know, let's be real. That's where we are. Inflation is really cutting into people's money. And then they're asking for people to have three times the rent. It's just, they want you to show that when you go to get a place. And I feel like it's just unrealistic. And we have to really meet people where they are. Okay, we have high inflation. We have this. We can't afford to raise the rent. Yes, we know that you're businesses, and we know you need to make your money too, but we have to have some common sense about what we're doing in terms of how much this rent is raising. Right. People can't afford it. I don't want to see more homeless people. That's just bananas. Right. And so my goal is really to step in, because homelessness is a layer. It's not always about mental health, like you said. It's not always about this thing where people, most people are one check away from being homeless. That's right. And those are facts. And so anything can happen in your life. You lose your job. Anything can happen or maybe something happened, you can't work. And so anything can trigger you to homelessness. That's what most people don't understand. So it's not that people are just mentally ill or things like that. Right. So that's something I definitely want to tackle, is homelessness. And this affordable housing is a real issue. I know there's a lot of pushback, because a lot of the real estate people, you know, they don't want it. But it's like, what's going to happen? They have processes in place. People don't know. I know all about SNAP and all these processes they have in place that you have to put your pay stubs through, and people using real pay stubs and are saying no. And then they're like, oh, you're declined. So these are real things that are happening out here. And so I'm very in tune with things that we need to do in terms of housing. And we have to be on top of that. We can't keep collecting homeless people. This is ridiculous. Right. We shouldn't want to see people unhoused. Mm-hmm. It is everyone's right to have a roof over their head. And if you don't think that, then something is wrong. Mm-hmm. You have no compassion. And so we have to really tackle that in real
time.
Bueno,
yo le hice una preguntita a Erika, que ella cómo iba a apoyar, cómo quiere apoyar homelessness, porque sabemos que por la inflación mucha gente no puede pagar sus rentas y terminan homeless. Ella precisamente ha estado homeless en el pasado. A ella le tocó ser homeless y ahora por eso ella sabe que ella ella quiere ayudar a nuestra comunidad para que no vuelva a pasar. And you know, it's very sad. Tell us a little bit about how the people can get involved with your campaign and where they can reach you.
You can go to my website. I'm at www.ericaforlasvegas.com. And so that's ericaforlasvegas.com. If they'd like to reach me, it's 702-550-9447. But I would love you to reach me. There are so many ways to connect with the campaign. We're looking for door knockers. We're looking for people that want a phone bank. We're looking for people to donate money. Y'all know candidates need money, and I'm not afraid to ask for it. I have a donate button right on my website that's ready for you to tap on and donate because you believe in what I've said here today. You believe in me as a candidate. You know that I'm the right choice for Ward 5, and I am the people's choice.